Well, there's been a heartbreaking setback for rescuers trying to reach 29 miners trapped in a New Zealand coal mine. 10 reporter Matt Doran joins us now with the details from Greymouth. Good morning, Matt. What can you tell us? What's the latest information from the ground there?
Well, Tash, 5 days now since the mystery blast that's left 29 men entombed in here on New Zealand's west coast. And still, the distraught families are really no closer to knowing whether their loved ones are dead or alive. Now, the country woke this morning to find the human faces of this disaster plastered across newspapers. And now it's gone on so long without answers, the grief really is starting to consume these small communities. Now, I've just received word a short time ago that the rescue operation has hit another hurdle. Engineers who worked through the night drilling a shaft towards the men, 162 metre shaft, have encountered great difficulty breaking through the last few metres of really hard rock. And in another blow just a short time ago, the Defence Force robot, which was sent into the tunnel to investigate the toxic gas levels inside, has malfunctioned. This was the explanation from police at a press conference a very short time ago.
They contacted me and told me the robot had broken down and is now inside the tunnel and no longer will be used. Parallel to the use of the Defence Force assets, we have been in contact with our colleagues in America in an effort to bring out an advanced robot from there. And parallel to that, we are negotiating with Western Australia to bring an advanced robot from them. We are liaising with New Zealand Air Force in an effort to have that hooked into me as soon as possible.
Now, this is, as we know, a hugely risky rescue operation, and that was highlighted overnight when a member of the drilling team became injured during that process. He was injured his ankle and had to be medevaced out to hospital. It's a slow operation, but they are making progress. Seismic monitoring device has been lowered down into the tunnel, and they're using that to listen for any tapping noises coming from inside.
They had to stop overnight from very hard rock that they encountered and go from an open hole rotary percussive drilling to a diamond bit coring, which we were going to do in the last 10 metres. We've now decided to do that for the last 20 metres just because it's too hard to drill.
And so the anguish just rolls on and on for these distraught families. Relatives of one of the Australian men trapped inside, 25-year-old Josh Ufa, arrived this morning. Understandably, they were too distraught to speak on camera.
Just a bit overwhelmed at the moment. I just want to go and have a break.
Hourly updates about the progress of this rescue operation, but really it's as the rescue goes on, it's by the minute that hopes of success are fading. Tash.
Matt Doran joining us from Greymouth. Thanks for the update.